in Houston, Texas, and this is CNN.
United Airlines is warning nearly half of its frontline workforce that they could be furloughed when restrictions on a federal bailout expire in October. So joining me now is our CNN aviation correspondent, Pete Muntean. Pete, what is United telling its employees?
Well, Brooke, one United employee tells me this is just downright heartbreaking. What is so interesting is that it was only a week ago that United said that it was going to ramp up its schedule for the month of August. Now it's going back on that promise, saying that we'll fly only 20% of the flights that it was flying this time last year. United says as cases of coronavirus started to surge again across the country, demand for flying actually went down, and now it's sending out furlough notices to 36,000 of its frontline employees. The lion's share of them flight attendants, 16,000 flight attendants, 11,000 in customer service, 2,250 pilots. United sent out this letter to all of its work groups. A part of the quote says, the reality is, with the conditions the way they are now, with travel so depressed, United cannot continue going forward like this. It is urging its employees to take voluntary leaves of absence, take early retirement packages. Airlines have said they would have to get smaller as this pandemic would drag on. And now we are seeing simply how small. United already got about $5 billion from the CARES Act, federal stimulus money. It's saying that there is probably not an appetite for another stimulus bill once again to bail out the airlines, even though United did just receive a loan from the Treasury to help it go forward. United says it's burning through $40 million each day, and this is not sustainable. That's why it's sending out these letters to its employees.
$40 million every day. Goodness. Pete Muntean, thank you for that update from United. And I just want to close today with a reminder. It's not the critic who counts, especially when that critic uses his primetime television perch to criticize someone who lost limbs for this country. The critic who has never served a day in his life has decided that the junior United States Senator from Illinois, Tammy Duckworth, despises America. His smears that the potential Democratic vice presidential nominee is a vandal, a fraud, and a moron revolve around Duckworth's suggestion that the U.S. should have a national conversation about removing monuments to the founding fathers, such as George Washington. Washington owned slaves, and Duckworth told our own Dana Bash, it is worth listening to those who say that is enough to merit taking those statues down. That suggestion, just to listen to that argument, according to the critic, is more akin to screaming about how horrible America is and that she cannot count herself among the many of us who do like this country. That, quite simply, is BS. Duckworth's record of service is how we know. Just looking at her is how we know. She has a Purple Heart, and she has the metal you see every day, the steel and titanium prosthesis attached to her thighs, and the wheelchair she uses to get around. Duckworth was on a routine mission in 2004 when a rocket-propelled grenade harpooned the floor of the Black Hawk helicopter she was flying. It burst into flames inside the cockpit, and her co-pilot presumed Duckworth was dead. But she wasn't. And she has spent every single day since that accident in the continued service of the country and the Illinois Army National Guard and the VA and in the Senate for a country a certain television critic has never risked life and limb to defend. That's it for me. I'm Brooke Baldwin. The Lead starts now.
Welcome to The Lead. I'm Pamela Brown in for Jake Tapper. And today, the United States passing a new alarming milestone. Take this in, more than 3 million confirmed cases of coronavirus with a new record high, 60,000 cases recorded in just one day, 60,000. This afternoon, Dr. Deborah Burke said states seeing a surge should avoid any kind of indoor gathering, though the White House task force also pushed for schools to reopen in the fall in just a few weeks. Vice President Pence claiming that the White House will be, quote, very respectful of local communities who decide not to reopen. But then President Trump earlier today threatened to cut off funding for schools that don't open. This all comes as at least 11 states see record high hospitalizations. I want to get right to CNN's Erica Hill with some breaking news. What are you learning, Erica?
So we're just getting some new numbers, Pamela, on the hospitalizations in the state of California.